coming to America.
Oh.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
Now let's talk about why this is great. Yes. That's one of the reasons why it's great.
Yeah. There you go.
Was the singing, the comedy.
Yep.
Another reason the movies that I'm going to really talk about was I base a movie on how many times I could watch it. And Coming to America is one of those movies. I literally watched it last night twice. And I'll go home and watch it again. It's just got that kind of vibe on. You know what I'm saying? It's the nostalgia. I don't even know how to explain it. But if you're a person that loves movies, obviously you've got to be if you're on this podcast listening to it. But right. I'm just saying. There's something that there's an essence there that just keeps drawing you in. And you're like, man, this is just such a great movie. I got to watch it again in case I missed something. And I can't even tell you how many times I've seen it in my lifetime. But last night, I could tell you it was twice. But it's got the romance. It's got the comedy. Then it had some actors who were fairly new, who we, you know. Back then, during the filming of this movie, Samuel L. Jackson, famous scene as the robber. Oh my goodness!
right.
And if you look closely, you'll see Cuba Gooding in the barbershop.
Uh huh. There you
and,
go.
And who else? Oh, Garciel Bouvier from the Jamie Foxx show. And something that I was
Arsenio.
Actually,
you gotta have Arsenio.
Oh yeah, of course. Arsenio Hall and Eddie Murphy in their other roles. It was fantastic. It was comedy genius.
It really was.
And
it really was.
A fun fact, I thought that this was known like to everyone, but I had a conversation with a friend of mine. There's a scene where Eddie Murphy gives some money to some homeless men. Two homeless men, right?
Randolph. Leave me alone, Mortimer. Randolph! I'm still not talking to you. Look.
And I was talking to a friend of mine. I was like, you know, these are the guys from Trading Places. And they were like,
Trading
what?
Places, yeah.
I was like, you didn't know that?
Oh,
okay.
Winthorpe, we're back.
Awkward.
Yeah.
Yes. It was Ralph Bellamy and Donna Meachie. And it was a crossover thing going on with Trading Places because they had lost their fortune in Trading Places and then they ended up. See, I love stuff like that. I'll be excited. I'll be like, yes, crossover the fields. Why don't you? But I thought everybody knew that. I was like, okay, well, I looked down on them, you peasant. No, but really, I have to understand that, you know, everybody doesn't love movies like I love movies. So, you know, I gave them a pass.
That's right.
That time.
Yeah. It's so many iconic moments in that movie. I believe it was the first time that an actor played multiple roles, because, you know, he was, of course, the prince. And then in the barbershop, he was two of those characters in the barbershop.
Yep.
He was a singer on stage. Sex and chocolate.
He said he was good and terrible. He was good and terrible.
Yeah, he was good. That's right. So,
gosh.
it was just a lot. You know what I mean? So it was great. It was groundbreaking. So many new things. And it was just hilarious. A hilarious movie from beginning to end.
Yes, for the black culture, it was definitely something great, you know, as far as like a black thumbprint in Hollywood. That's definitely one of those that we can celebrate or whatnot. Definitely.
Right.
Gotcha.
Right.
Okay, and another reason that I love a movie, like I can rewatch it again and again, that this is an example of a movie where people pull movie lines from. There are so many. I could just start now and it would just be, I'm in love with Lisa. Isn't that wonderful? I mean, it's just so many. You know. Man, you ain't never met Martin
really
Luther King.
Is.
Oh, man, you lying. You ain't never met Martin Luther the King. Knocked the wind out of me. Yes, he did. No, it didn't. Yes, he did. No, he did not.
Okay, well, you know.
He ain't never Martin Luther King. You're right.
Ralph Macchiato. Every white person would bring out Rafael Macchiano. Look, I can't let me stop. But if you have not, I'm sure there's someone out there that has never seen Coming to America. Make sure you see Coming to America. And before the sequel comes out, which I believe is